Stable diffusion is chained to the limits of its understanding, but in this video we will break those chains and allow you to create the best possible images. Here we have the prompt we made in the last video. As you can see right here, it was made using the Ivory B12 model. And you may ask, why is that important? Well, if you try to follow along, even if you had everything exactly like me, if you weren't using this model, the results would have been very different. Here is the result the same image gives me using the default Stable Diffusion model.
Pretty bad, right?
Yeah.
So, what exactly is the model and how much does it affect our images?
Without going into technicalities, the model is like the artist, to whom you give a text and it transforms it into images. So, different artists will understand the same text in different ways.
And now that we have established that models are important, where can you actually get them?
Well, like always, CBTAI. Click on Models and sort by highest rated. And here, look for images that have this checkpoint text. These are the models. Like every artist, each model has its own preferred style, strengths and shortcomings, depending on the images it was trained on. Most models will provide this information down here, including the preferred samples, aspect ratios and other stuff, as well as the current version of it. You can check the images generated by the users to check each model's capabilities, and then choose a model that excels at what you want to do. And that's why if I prompt a portrait illustration model with my cat prompt, it will not follow the photo or the realistic part, and it may understand the whole prompt differently compared to the Ivory B12 model. But if I wanted to create a high contrast anime style person, the roles would reverse, and that's even though Ivory is a really versatile model. Now, back to CBTA. You can also see the files that will be downloaded and the size of the model. Sometimes down here or in the model's description, you may find a "this model includes a bay text." The bay is like a filter that applies while the image is still generating. So if you see that some of your images have really muted colors, it might be because you have no bays. You can download these files from the CBTA links and then just move them into this folder right here. Then go to Settings, Stable Diffusion, click this blue icon right here, select the one that you downloaded, and then the bay will be applied every generation. You have to save the settings though. You can also leave it in automatic, as there are some models that have a baked bay, which is a bay that applies either you have the file or not. By the way, when you download a model, go to the Models folder, then the Stable Diffusion, and then paste it right here. If it isn't loading, try clicking the blue icon.
Yeah, all of this is very cool, but I was told that you were gonna generate this image, but with your cat instead. There's a problem though, why would Stable Diffusion know how to make an image of my cat? It doesn't even know his name, so...
What if I told you that you can teach Stable Diffusion new things that it didn't know how to do before?
Like Simbito, my cat.
For this, we will use LORAS and Embeddings. They are slightly different, but they boil down to the same thing. A file that teaches Stable Diffusion anything you need. It can be an object, a character, a style, maybe an action, even a new concept like, okay, not this, how to create textures, for example, right?
There are some technical differences between LORAS and textual inversions, but these are the ones that you really want to know about.
If it's a LORA, just save it in the LORAS folder. Using them is quite simple. Click this icon right here in the middle and a short window will appear. Here, you have all your teaching files, including embeddings. You can quickly access your LORAS in this tab right here. Now, just by clicking on the one that you will use, it will automatically place it on the positive prompt. You can also type it by yourself, but make sure you add this special text in front and behind. The one behind this double dot marks the intensity of the LORA. Before clicking generate, I suggest you check the LORA's recommendation. Usually, the poster will tell you at what strength the LORA works best, and if it has any trigger word. The trigger words are usually necessary to activate the LORA when generating. Some of them may be optional. Like for example, in this character pack, you can choose who the LORA will generate by typing their name. Usually, I check the poster's image prompts to see how the LORA is used, as sometimes there are non-specified keywords that you might need. Personally, I have a text file with all my LORAs, as well as their respective keywords, just in case I forget or I can't find the CBTA's page again. For the files that say textual inversion, go to this embeddings folder. Using them is even easier than LORAS, as they usually don't have any keywords other than the embeddings name itself, which will appear just by clicking it in the embeddings tab. No need for weird text this time, just treat it like a regular word. The only weird thing embeddings have is that it isn't uncommon to see them as negative embedding. These are embeddings that are used in the negative prompt instead of the positive. Depending on how the LORA or embedding was trained, the concept will be better understood and have more or less bleeding. For example, this character LORA has a strong style bleeding, and it is really hard to tone down without losing the main character. This is called an overbaked LORA.
I'll do a tutorial on how to train these models if there is a demand for it, but in this example I trained a lora of my cat with these images and these descriptions for each image. To show you that loras actually work, here's an AI's attempt to create Jinx from Fortnite. Even if we try to describe her, it doesn't work. Now, using this lora, ta-da, the chain has been broken and now we can teach Stable Diffusion whatever we need. Now, it's time to implement the lora for our image. Let's type the prompt I used for the image and replace cat for the lora at 6 strength, switching with cat at step 7, and then I put another cat with a lower weight. If this was a properly trained lora, just replacing cat by the lora and the keyword would have sufficed. But it was my first lora, so I didn't really train it that well. To apologize, let me teach you some cool models and loras I really, really like. And this way, you will also see the power that these tools can give us. I'm sorry, what is that? Oh, you wanna learn what that interface was back there? Don't worry, that was for the next lesson, so don't miss it. Okay, this is a list of models that I usually use. My personal favorite is Ivory. It is a very versatile model and I love its style. For photorealism, nothing beats realistic vision. As far for anime style goes, I really like Counterfeit. But if you want even more anime style, you can use abysshellmaple. Deliverate version 2 is another versatile model that a ton of people use, including myself. This is one model I don't really use, but I have seen what it does and it is amazing. RevAnimated. As long as loras and embeddings go, easynegative is a really cool negative embedding. A good enhancer lora is epiNoiseOffset, and if you like creating pixel art, the best is PixHell lora. And a personal favorite of mine, LeagueofLegends, to create cool splashered-like images.